I know what to do. Show me some. That's another sack, cause I be running through it. I set up the play, I'ma make a move.
Audible.
It's gonna be a blitz if I run into you.
Go.
When the kick off the bone, run it back. Home. Hail Mary, pray the feds don't intercept the pack. Familiar with the struggle, look, I'm coming up from scratch. Nothing hold up with my pain, then I turned it to some rats.
Celebrate.
Nothing motivate me more than when I hear the crowd roar. Chant my name in the stands, I got drums, I got bands. Same ones that was hating, buying tickets, now they fans. Call a blitz, they don't see you, they gon' tackle your. Let's get activated, let's get activated. Let's get activated, let's get activated. Go. QB in the pocket, let it go, them bullets penetrate. When you in that field, let it feel, just stay dedicated. Go.
Put me in the game, I know what to do.
Show me something.
That's another sack, cause I be running through it. I set up the play, I'ma make it. It's gonna be a blitz if I run into you.
Go.
Pop out, treat this block like an end zone. What?
Score.
Check it. Benji calling money my ringtone.
104.
Blue, put her in the friend zone. Take one for the team. I do that for my boys.
Bread.
Gang.
Time ticking. I'ma give it all until the last minute. Set up the block just for my man. I bet we win it. Go hard or go home. It's survival of the fittest. Whoa.
Let's get activated, let's get activated.
Activate.
Let's get activated, let's get activated. QB in the pocket, let it go, them bullets penetrate. When you in that field, it get real, just stay dedicated. Go.
Put me in the game, I know what to do. That's another sack, cause I be running through it. I set up the play, I'ma make a move. It's gonna be a blitz if I run into you.
Making industry music, they want me to cap to y'all, but ain't gon' cap to y'all, cause y'all went there when they ain't had a ball. He tough as body, wonder how he felt watching his dog casket fall. I had to tell my YG stop, he don't like to pass the ball. That ticket he talking thick hit, I was kicking in houses for it. That's two different tickets, right? Oh yeah, they loud, boy. Them players lazy, they don't get no bread. Yeah, they be couching, boy. Them labels scouting, boy. They talking M's only the thousand, boy.
We are pleased, as always, to be bringing you coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. Today, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the Chicago Bears and the Los Angeles Rams. And off we go from SoFi Stadium. Yeah, that'll be a little too hot to handle as it will skip through the end zone for a touchback here. Right out of the gate, we're going to get a delay, so that'll back him up five. Now they need 15 yards on this series after the delay of game. First and 15. Wilson. And he'll be corralled well upfield right around the 40-yard line.
Well, he was a busy man out of the backfield a week ago. They got the ball early and often. I have no doubt in my mind that he'll be a big part of the game plan here as well.
So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. And they'll run for the first time with Najee Harris. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And it'll be second and very short. Well, no slow start here. A couple nice chunk plays back to back.
I love the momentum that they're showing here early because they did it both ways, right? Threw the ball on first down for a nice chunk of yardage. Came right back and ran the ball. Looks like they've got the defense set back on their heels. Let's see if they can keep this moving.
A good position to be in here, second and inches. From midfield now, here's Wilson. That's swung out wide to Harris. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42.
I'm not sure that this play was designed for him specifically, but they got through the progressions and got the ball to him. So second catch on the drive. He may not be a primary guy, but they definitely want him involved, don't they?
Absolutely. This early, the opening drive, as you said, two catches. So if they can get him going in the passing game, that should open up his running game too. Now a first down carry for Harris. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. This defense for the Rams, terrific last week in the season opening victory.
Yeah, and what stood out to me on tape, the way they were flying to the football. So that tells me that they've got all their assignments down and they're playing with extreme confidence.
Again, it's Harris on second down. A solid stiff arm and taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. Quite the opening drive march they're on right now.
It looks a lot like what we saw in practice prior to the game, doesn't it? You know, because on that last big practice beforehand, you go through your offensive script, you go through your play calling, you go through all the stuff and establish things, and it looks like it's going like clockwork right now for them.
From the red zone now, here's Wilson on first down. To the right side, he's got Cooper, it's complete. They'll contain him to just 4, second down. Now it's Wilson. That is caught at the 7-yard line. And he's dropped just before the line to gain. 4-yard pickup leaves him with 3-1. From the gun on third down, Wilson. Touchdown, Bears! Darnell Mooney, his first touchdown of the new season. And the Bears take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. Santos able to tack on the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. Now after the touchdown here, Santos to kick this one away. Pulls it in at the 13. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20. Call it the 21. Tannehill a throw out wide that's complete. No gain there on the completion. Second and 10.
No gain on the play. Brings up second and 10.
Here's the first carry of the game for Cam Akers. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3. To throw, Tannehill. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he is going to have a Rams first down. It won't be by much. He needed 3, and he got 3, barely. But the mark shows first down.
A
32 now. Here's first and 10. Here's Tannehill. That's out to the flat for Akers. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And it'll be second and about a yard to go for the first. Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45.
Defensively, they came into the game with the understanding they're going to have to slow him down on passes just like this because he was over 100 yards receiving a week ago. And you know they want to get him involved here as well.
After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. Couple of first downs to kick off the drive. Here's first and 10 up at the 46. To the air again, Tannehill. Oh, he was hit as he threw it there, and that one winds up incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
To throw again on second down, Tannehill. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. Now play number 7 of the drive as they're looking at a 3rd and 10. Here's Tannehill. And this pass broken up. The contact well timed there, and now 4th down.
One thing you hope to see out of a rookie tight end is a real concentration when the ball's in the air, and I'm not sure that he didn't, but he has to be prepared for people making a play on it when that ball's up for grabs.
Here's Thomas. Good blocking there, nearly sprung him. As it is, it'll go as a 19-yard return. And the Bears take over. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. They have to be thrilled with that first drive that got them the touchdown. Now they'll be looking to make it a 2-score advantage here on the road.
And you know they spent all week in practice, in meetings, talking about taking an early advantage. Being the road team, going up a score, that takes the crowd out of the game and puts some doubt in the minds of their opponents.
And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, but frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, lived to fight another down, right?
And that'll be incomplete. The flag was down, so they took a shot, thinking it's on the defense. Let's see. So the penalty certainly helps them out as they come up on 2nd and 5. To throw is Wilson. Open man is Komet, the tight end.
When an offense reads blitz, doesn't matter where it's coming from, tight ends know that they become a big part of the passing game because there should be an easy outlet when all those extra bodies are trying to get to the quarterback. A hot route, so to speak.
Looking deep in the direction of Cooper. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. And he's finally out of bounds, but he's taken it all the way down to the 8. A huge play there for Chicago. Throwing is Wilson. Dancing to his left. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
That was a touchdown if he could have hung on. Instead, it was a well-timed collision to jar that one free.
Second down and goal. Wilson. That is caught at the 7-yard line. Touchdown! Russell Wilson with 2 first-half touchdown passes. And the Bears will add on to their lead. Santos with the extra point. And that'll make the score 14-0.
Bears 14, Rams nothing. Cairo Santos to kick off for Chicago.
Now after the touchdown here, Santos to kick this one away. Pulls it in at the 13. And he'll be stopped up at the 25. At set to begin their next drive. The Rams offense at the line. They're staring at a two-touchdown deficit, 14-0 to score as they regroup with first and 10. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. Just what you want on a first down run, call it 8 yards, and it's second and 2. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39.
I'm okay with the call there. In fact, I actually like it. I know they're down a couple of scores, but the running game worked in that situation. I would continue to go in that direction.
And this throw a bit late as he couldn't reach back for it.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
Here's a throw out wide complete to his running back right side. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. First down with Akers. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
A good run, got 7 on first. Here's 2nd and 3. They'll run out of the gun with Akers. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a 3rd down. From the gun, here's Tannehill. He'll dump this off to Akers. A beautiful fake. And he's going to have another 1st down as the tackle's made here at the Bears 35. 2 minutes to play, 1st half. It's 14-0. A reminder coming up at halftime, we'll head to Orlando. Standing by there, Jonathan Coachman. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL in this 2nd week of the regular season. Throw right side here, taken in by Bateman. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. They'll contain him to just 4. 2nd down. Meanwhile, Tannehill's throw complete there to Bateman.
A gain of 9 yards. That's good for an LA Rams.
Again, Tannehill. Over the middle, that's hauled in by Kopp. A gain of 6 there on first.
Fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes and they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air. And sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there as they were able to connect. 3rd and 2, Tannehill. And he fires one that's intercepted. It's the former Seahawk, Earl Thomas. And now off to the races, down the right side. And they will score a pick 6 for a Bears touchdown.
Part of what we just saw, that's a great example of a team that was really amped up. They've been playing so well, yet they didn't get overexcited and have a bust on defense and gave up a big play. Instead, they created their own big play with a pick 6. This one may be over.
Yeah, it's just the 1st half, but that lead has swelled to the point where you're wondering if it is over already.
Taken at the 15, a short kick. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And with a 3-score deficit staring him in the face, they might have to... And a big loss here as he's taken down. After the sack, oh, they're staring at a challenge basically from the other side of town. It's 2nd and a country mile. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And with just 4 seconds left in this 1st half, a timeout call. The final shot here before the break, Tannehill. Rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Johnson. And he will be brought down on what will be the final play of this 1st half. So we reach halftime with the visiting Bears out on top here. As we send you to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach?
Both these teams, no doubt, making their final halftime adjustments as we speak. And for the call of the second half, we get it back out to Brandon Gunn and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. The Rams set to receive the second half kickoff, and they trail here as we resume play. Looking up into the... Oh, and this is going to wind up a safety. And the safety there, another mistake, and these mistakes just keep piling up.
How many more can they make? They put themselves in such a massive hole now. Going to be difficult to dig out from under.
Yeah, for sure they can't afford any more at this point.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive.
And it's hard to imagine that the first half could have gone any better for them. So what's the approach here in the second half?
Just continue to play smart football because they got the other team down and they feel good about the position they're in.
Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. Touchdown, Chicago!
Well, you normally talk about the mobility and the accuracy first, but the arm strength, that's what can turn Russ into danger, Russ.
Wilson gonna throw for it. And the Bears are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
I think this is just going to be a function of the times we live in now. Very similar to the bat flip in baseball. Everyone's got to start to get comfortable with this. But to me, this is just rubbing it in. You got a big lead. Go ahead and take the extra point. One thing to keep in mind, though, karma's still out there. And sometimes it has a way of catching up with you.
A fairly short kick from the 14. And he'll get it up just past the 20 as his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And following the interception, just any interception, pressure, and he's taken down. A Bears sack. And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19. Here's a throw right side, taken in by his tight end. And all the way to the opposite 48. A big play there for L.A. So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete.
You get the sense that they're saying we're not playing up to what we're capable of and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able
to... And a big loss here as he's taken down. Robert Quinn picks up his second sack of the afternoon. Now on third and forever, he'll look to throw. He's going to fire this thing deep right sideline.
And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far.
Picked off by Bryce Callahan.
And the Bears will take over possession here up at the 44.
At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up, whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook. One play drive is exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was fairly easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
Yeah, we'll see if it's that easy here.
Harris going to get it again on second down. And he's going to take this one across midfield and into Ram territory.
44 yards on the ground for him so far.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time and making it work.
Now on third down, that pass knocked down in the backfield and incomplete.
Coverage was awfully tight there on third down. They actually closed off all the passing lanes, forcing the incompletion and bringing up fourth down.
Hey, Mike's 50, Mike's 50.
You want this?
They'll try and throw for it with Wilson. He's going to have his running back. It's complete. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line.
And that's a big pickup of a first down. And you know that all week, both sides of the ball, offense and defense, are going through every situation. And in this case, the offensive guys had the right play dialed up because defensively, you work on fourth down situations as well.
And deflating for the defense. They can't get the stop here. So 8 yards on the completion there, and that'll make it second down.
Brings up second and two at the 32-yard line.
A run with Harris out of the shotgun. And only able to get two here. Stopped at the 30.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had